Jay, this is Pam from the Royal Rocketeers. First, I want to acknowledge a missing member, Matthew Johnson. He built these models and he did all the flying, lots of flights, and I want to make sure he gets acknowledgement for it. So this is on the, it's yet another helicopter presentation. So far. Effective rotor length on flight duration and failure rate of D rotor helicopter rockets. Next slide. So the primary objective was to see what effect varying the helicopter length, rotor length had on performance or duration. Full length or short. I never give much thought to how long to make the rotors. If the rocket's this long, then the rotors are about this long. And if it's a rosa rock, they come to the top of the fins. And if it's a rotor rock, they go all the way between the fins. They're long, as long as you can make them. But is that necessarily the best? So the hypothesis to be tested is, would a decrease in the length of the rotor from, let's say, full length, 18 inches in this case, to 10 inches, a little over half size, on an otherwise identical D impulse helicopter, will that significantly decrease flight duration? And then we added another objective, and that is looking at the mechanical failure rates on these to see if it correlates with rotor length. And we heard from Alan's presentation that sometimes it does. Okay, next slide. So this was a Chicago chopper style helicopter. Looks kind of like a rotor rock, but the some or all of the body tube and motor and fin unit drops out. It's tethered by a cord to a separate rotor assembly. Right. So we had two rotor assemblies, one with 10-inch rotors, one with 18-inch rotors, and we used a single booster section for all the flights, trying to isolate the variable of rotor length away from any other variables. One engine type, D12-3, actually we generated a partial data set with C6 engines, C6-3s, and that said they just weren't flying high enough to give a good duration and too much variability, not enough time on the durations. So he upped it to D12s, which worked fine enough for this purpose. We'll see average flight time to around 25 seconds, give or take, which is fine, you know, from an analysis point of view. We're probably saying, well, that's not very good for a D helicopter. These were built sturdy, though. And Pam, can you hold up maybe the longer ones, longer rotor assembly? Because remember, we wanted to go through 30 to 60 flights without any major repairs, including plan for some crashes. We wanted it to survive the crashes. But the longer one here, I think, is separate from the other two. So that's the longer one. And the shorter one she has in her hand is still tethered to the body tube we use. You can kind of see there that body tube's been through a lot.
At least 60 flights on this tube. 30 on each of these.
But that body tube's gone through over 60 flights. Wow. And it was still in use up to the last flight. Okay. And there's pictures on the next slide, Pam.
Just a minute, I'm being
slow. Won't give you a hand. And here's just pictures of what you just saw. This is what the body tube looked like before it had all the blue tape on it. And the next slide. And here they are ready for launch. And you can see it's the full length blades are 18 inches. These are 10 inches, which is a 44% reduction in blade length. And since they're just rectangular blades, 44% reduction in blade area as well. So you would think, okay, shorter blades, less lifting area, a shorter duration. That was the hypothesis we wanted to test. Next slide. This is the flight log. This is the raw data. So you can see we got 15 flights, D3s, out of the shorter blades. These are the 10-inch ones. And 14 from the longer 18-inch blades. That's about where we planned to stop, but we had to stop here because on the 15th flight here, there was a separation and the larger blade assembly went flying away by itself and was lost. So, 15 versus 14. The ones in red have an explanation that involves some kind of mechanical failure. And that's going to be removed from the data for statistical analysis. But right away, you kind of notice there's more down here, the longer blades.
than there are here. We'll talk about that a little later. Next slide.
So this is the data scrubbed of the mechanical failures. You see there's, I mean, there's some thermals that have longer times, 36 seconds. There's some non-vertical boosts that have shorter times, like 20 seconds. Those are more aerodynamic effects than mechanical failures. But this is what we got. So we got 12 keeper flights with the short rotors, and we got 7 with the longer rotors. And we did descriptive stats, so means and standard deviations for each group independently. So the mean time here is 94.95 seconds, plus or minus 6.55 seconds. And for the long rotors, it was 26.44, plus or minus 5.53. So this is a little longer than this, so maybe the longer blades did work better, but really there's only a second and a half difference in the means. So we did comparative stats, students t-test to tailed, and generated p-value that's only, it's a 0.60, so it's nowhere near the cutoff of 0.05%, which is convention for saying something statistically different from another group. So we failed to disprove the null hypothesis, so these are statistically the same as each other. Okay, next slide. This is the actual distribution of the flights. Each of these is a data point. These are the means here, and the error bars are one standard deviation. So you see the means are within a second and a half of each other. These are thermals up here, and these are non-vertical boosts down here. But the nominal flights were actually pretty clustered pretty close. Next slide. So after removing the mechanical failures, the mean durations were only different by 1.49 seconds. The small difference is not significant, p is 0.6. 44% reduction did not reduce performance. That's a little bit unexpected. However, the shorter rotors appeared to have a lower failure rate, 20%, versus the longer rotors, which tended to get tangled in the Kevlar, or they wouldn't deploy completely, or one wouldn't deploy completely. So they had a 50% failure rate. Next slide. The 10-inch rotors appeared to rotate about 2 to 3 times faster than the 18-inch rotors. So that is probably the explanation for the fact that you got less lifting surface, but the same lift apparently, same duration. They're just moving faster. So this is a crude number. It's based on visual observation by Matt and also limited slow motion frame-by-frame analysis of it coming down in video. But it's not the right kind of analysis to really say that's a firm number.
2 minutes.
Okay. Rotor length testing should be included when you optimize design of a helicopter rocket, is what we're thinking about. And not just assuming that longer is better. Because sometimes longer is the same, and the failure rate is higher with longer blades. Mechanical failure rates should also be factored into the design. One more slide, last slide. So we looked and we found over 20 R&D reports in the database on helicopters, one way or another, but only one that specifically dealt with rotor length up until Alan's report today. And that's Mary Wolf. Way back when in NARM 44 when you were an A divisioner, I believe. So Mary dropped helicopters from that tower at Baum, I think is the one. Different lengths.
Left hand peak.
Yep.
A little different.
Starting at 24 inch and then literally chopping off pieces until she got down to 9 inches and recorded the duration of the drop from the tower. And then used the otolite tracking of one size, I guess, and then used RockSim to estimate based on that actual flight performance, taking into the descent rate. And predicted that the 15 and 18 inch lengths would outperform shorter and longer rotors, right? The 24 and 21 would not have performed as well. And so what our results are very consistent with Mary's, and we extended it to use actual flight data for two of the sizes, showing that longer rotors are not necessarily going to give you better performance than shorter ones and may have a higher failure rate, depending on the model. I'll stop there. I think I'm about out of time anyway.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
two questions. First up, don't you just hate it when a thermal screws with your data?
Yeah.
And secondly, did Royal Rocketeer, I wasn't paying much attention as to who was flying what yesterday, although I was out of the field. Did Royal Rocketeers enter the event, and how well did you do?
We took second place with one flight. That was with long rotors. We toyed with the idea of cutting rotors down for the second flight, but since we were gunning for first, we flew it in the same configuration, but I was removing some of the black powder from the G motor so it wouldn't destroy the rotor assembly on the way out. And removed a little bit too much, but crash. So,
oh dear.
We may see it again on the Midwest Trophy.
When he brought it back, I said, "Oh my gosh, it's an Acme Spitfire."
So how long did you say the rotors were in your competition model?
So they actually were what we would call full length for this model. So this was a internal blade model. So we don't really have anything. It would have been a N of one in each group comparison of a different model. So we didn't quite get that.
I don't have any questions. So does the audience have questions?
When you build your rotors, how do you maintain or make sure that each rotor is assembled at a given angle of attack?
So I can just look at what Matt did. I wasn't involved, but this is, oh wow, that just snapped.
I know, they're attacking me.
Yeah. This looks like the QCR kit with that diagonal slice across the full length of the rotor, and when he went from full length to half length, he still had a diagonal slice across the full length of the rotor, and he had with the same dimensions, but it was just a steeper angle. It was just short. Everything was just short. Okay. Nothing else was changed. And of course, anytime you do that, there's variability in the false quality and in the exact angle. He made an attempt to make them as close as he could to each other.
Right. Any more questions from the audience?
Damn.
How much did you spend on orders?
Oh, I'll know when I get the receipt from Matt, but actually it's in the budget. How much was it? 180 or something like that?
I hope you know how good an order is.
I have a connection.
Anyone else? Okay, thank you very much.
Here, please take a second.
13 feet.